Thank you for coming. My name is Tyrone Jefferson, and this is the seventh and last program for Digging History Through Music and Dance.
Well, first of all, you know, we have a lot of line dances out here, but this particular one is more of a conscious line dance. It has a little old school flavor to it, especially after hearing the song that Mr. Tyrone asked us to move to. Each movement, you know, even when I do choreography, each movement has to have a meaning behind it. It just can't be a movement. There is some significance for it. So like the first movement, it's like a cha-cha. So you can demonstrate 5, 6, 7, 8, and okay. Now, old school, you all remember, I'm from Philadelphia, and this is what we used to do. We used to cha-cha all the time. So the movement, one second. So. Very strategic, very intentional, just like the movement of the civil rights, just like all the movements that took place in our history. It was strategically planned. So that's why I selected that movement. Old school, but yet it has some significance to it. The next move. Now, if you see their hands, just a second. You see their arms are positioned. It reminded me of the Birmingham, Kelly Ingram's Park, where you saw the youth standing, being hosed down by the fire hose. They stood firmly along with each other. Come here a second. But it was more of a lock. So in this movement, you'll see this, which is symbolic of that, holding that chain, holding each other up. This next movement. Now, that movement is taken from a precursor, which is, I think, the precursor of all line dances, called the black body. Who's ever heard of the black body? Okay, so when they swing their arms back, they're grabbing hold to their pants. Because you don't want to get caught with your pants down. Mr. Tyrone calls it the cotton shackles. We see boys running around. I have no idea why, but they have their pants all the way down, almost close, just a second, you know, close to the knees. I mean, if they would run, definitely they would get caught, am I right? I've seen them holding their buckles, you know, it just looks, I don't understand. But anyway, they swing their arms back, grabbing their pants, and then they'll do a motion that looks like this, and they'll go down, and they pull, and their pants up. Very simple, just something simplistic, a lot of fun, but at the same time, it's conscious. It's reminding you. The next move. Okay, who remembers to tighten up? Now, up north, who's it to tighten up? Here. What's that? What'd you call it? Okay, the funky four corners. We called it tighten up. Okay, so the arms are positioned here.
You got it?
The arms are positioned here. Very strong. Tighten up. Getting ready. Preparing yourself. You know, I think Brother Jamal Turner mentioned about tightening up, you know, lining things up, being prepared to move in the movement. So that's what this movement is symbolic of. So the next movement is. Now, you remember the camel walk. The camel walk, again, symbolic moving forward with the black power sign. I've seen this movement, the South African movement, when they do the chants. So it all comes back around. So, and when they do this, your head is up, your fist is up, saying, I'm moving forward. I'm moving through any obstacle. Nothing can break me. Nothing will stop me, that's what the movement is symbolic of. So then the next movement is, okay, you're gonna try to alter my direction, I'm gonna navigate. So you just keep moving. You keep moving nonstop. All right? Oh, come on, let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. So you reclaim it. You're taking a stand, you're reclaiming. You're preparing yourself. Think about Kelly Ingram's Park. Think about the Edmund Pettus Bridge. Think about the March on Washington. Think about Stokely Carmichael, Bobby Seals, Angela Davis, Martin Luther King. This is a conscious line dance. All right.
It's gonna be on YouTube.
You know,
cha-cha.
You know.